Evander Holyfield has earned his place in boxing's history books and the millions that go with it. And yet in the early hours of Saturday morning, he'll climb into the ring with Mike Tyson. So what is it that's driven Holyfield from the lap of luxury into the ring of fear?
Evander Holyfield is a boxing legend who's dedicated his life to the sport. He's got everything a man could want. Why fight Tyson? Look at me
standing here on my own again. People always told me what I couldn't do, and I've always been able to prove that they are wrong because I don't walk by what people say.
A legendary warrior. World cruiserweight champion. World heavyweight champion. And the wars with Riddick Bowe.
Why are you fighting on November the 9th?
You know, I love what I'm doing. And this thing is not just so much for myself. This is so much for the world.
He's the perfect role model, an idol for kids in America.
$100 million in the bank he's got. Why is he taking this?
That question is entirely up to him. But as long as he fight, I'll support him. Didn't care if he got $1 billion in the bank.
Look at me stand. He has all that money can buy.
I'm already rich in the blood, so you know the whole thing is that it's not so much the money.
Tyson is the ultimate. He's the only thing left. It's the way to finish the last big battle.
Tyson and I in the ring. Now it's time for us to get it on. Then when it's over, then we just shake hands and say, hey, you know, good fight.
Well, money is clearly not the object. Is it purely the fact that it's Tyson, Duke?
Evander Holyfield, for me, is the ultimate warrior, and he doesn't know when to say stop, you know. But I think, fortunately for, like, Holyfield, he's just said, he's got all the trappings of wealth, and I don't know what drives him on personally, but I think he, for me, represents everything that a world champion should be, both inside and outside of the ring. You know, he's a clean-cut guy. You know, he doesn't do the normal sort of things that most heavyweights do, and like inside the ring, that's where he is like the boss as well, in my opinion anyway. I think once the bell goes, Tyson can't be like intimidated, you know, Holyfield can't be intimidated. You know, it doesn't matter what Tyson says or what the people around him say, once the bell goes, you know, it's just like Tyson and Holyfield, and I personally am going for the upset, because I think this guy is just, if he can take Tyson past like about 5-6 rounds, then it's just going to be a whole new ball game to Tyson. Because, you know, 90% of like Tyson's victims have all been beaten before the fight. They've been beaten by the fear. They've been beaten
That's
by
right.
that Tyson
Holyfield
aura.
Says he can cope with that sort of pressure.
And I think he can. You know, the guy's been there, seen it and done it. You know, he's worn the T-shirt, read the book. And I think that Tyson's, he's only like a small heavyweight. All right, he's got speeds and he can punch and he can do all the rest of it. But, like, for me, Holyfield will prevail mentally and physically.
Jeff, just caught me indulging in one of the great rituals of any big fight week in Las Vegas. It's the buying of the souvenirs to prove to all your friends you really were there. There's the Tyson Holyfield sweatshirt. There's the Tyson Holyfield grey T-shirt. There's the black version in case you've got a colour clash. I know what it can be like. You've got to be coordinated these days. There's also the sweatshirt for outdoor wear. Lots and lots of posters. And the obligatory souvenir hats. Put it all together. Margaret, are people really buying all this stuff as souvenirs? Okay, for the whole lot, I've got a lot of friends to look after back home. How much can you do a deal for?
I can let you have all this for $100.
You're a hard woman. I'll go away and think about it. Thanks anyway. One way and another, it's a truly commercial knockout for all the people involved in selling souvenirs and all the other paraphernalia here in Las Vegas. And the other people who profit so handsomely in Big Fight Week are the people running the betting. I'm off to the sports books now to find out who's been banking on who. Right, Craig, here we are in the sports book. How big a betting event is the big heavyweight showdown at the weekend?
Well, compared to the elections this week, This thing's going through the roof. We've been waiting for 5 years for this fight. When Tyson's in town, it's Tyson Mania. Some people have sentimental favorite for Holyfield, but Tyson's the odds-on favorite.
Okay, thanks, Craig. Jeffrey?
You have been known to have the odd punt in your life. I hope we've marked your card.
Thanks very much indeed, Paul. You have indeed, but Duke McKenzie has, actually. But you're going to have a small flutter on Holyfield, then.
Yeah, I'm not a gambling man at all, but I do feel that Evander Holyfield is going to pull off, like, one of the biggest shocks ever, because I just think he's going to have too much heart, desire and commitment for Mike Tyson.
Evander, the real deal Holyfield.
What a shot by Evander Holyfield!
Has fought in some of the greatest battles in the history of heavyweight boxing.
Oh, he's got him in a left hook!
5 years ago, he was due to meet Mike Tyson.
And Tyson is down!
Tyson lost his title. Holyfield lost his chance.
I'm not tested to outfight Mike Tyson.
Now live on Sky Box Office, the pay-per-view event Judgment Night Part 2.
I want to prove to the world that I'm better than Tyson.
Finally, Mike Tyson faces Evander Holyfield.
It'll come down to the two best guys.
A world championship fight 5 years in the making.
You're going to see a great fight.
Judgment Night Part 2, Saturday from midnight, exclusive to Sky.
He was heavyweight champion of the world. One of the best boxers of the decade. Afraid of no man. He'll fight anyone who wants to fight. That's why he'll fight Mike Tyson. That's why he's Evander Holyfield.
Jeffrey, like I've told you so many times in the past, life is a beach. And here in Las Vegas, the MGM Grand, the hotel with everything, venue for the big fights on Saturday night, has to have a beach, it's got everything else. Here taking the sunshine in the morning with me is the Colonel, Bob Sheridan, big fight commentator for Showtime Network, going out around the world on Saturday night. Bob, it's been a pretty predictable head-to-head at the start of this week in the United States. The presidential race has gone according to form, all the newspapers telling us.
As you see in the USA Today, they predicted the breeze for Clinton, and again here in the Review Journal in Las Vegas, they talk about it, and as well in the Los Angeles Times. Very predictable, the political race. Boxing, I don't think so.
You think it could be less predictable on Saturday night, Evander Holyfield against Mike Tyson?
Well, you listen to all the writers and all the broadcasters from around the world, and there's no reason to have the fight. But anytime you put two heavyweights in there, especially one that has shown the tremendous heart of Evander Holyfield, you've got a war in your hands. How long it'll go is the question. Whether it'll be into the second, third, fourth, and on, we don't know. But it'll be a war at some stage.
Bob, you've seen so many of these big fights in Las Vegas, but even, what, in your 25 years here, you've never been involved in a bill where we have three world heavyweight title fights on the same bill. This takes it into a new sphere, doesn't it?
Oh, it certainly does. This is a great night for boxing. All you people will be watching Sky around the UK and all over Europe. I want to tell you one thing. Don't miss this night of boxing. You got three heavyweight championship fights. Never before happened. Never before. And on top of that, no matter what happens in the Tyson-Holyfield fight, it's a fight you can't miss. Remember what happened with Buster Douglas? Well, Douglas had less of a shot than Holyfield has. You can't miss a championship fight when the heavyweight title of the world is on the line. And that's the way it's going to be Saturday night.
Okay, Bob, finally, one final thought. It does seem as though the big head-to-heads are going with form. Bill Clinton wins this week. On all known form, does Mike Tyson take a step closer to becoming the unquestioned best heavyweight in the world again this week?
Oh, I don't think there's any question about it. In my mind right now, Tyson is clearly the number one heavyweight, and then all the rest of them are all grouped together. Anyone from 2 down to 20 could knock anyone else off on a given night. That's why the other two heavyweight championship fights are such classic events. Tyson clearly number one.